Okay, looks like we're back on. I now know to avoid this page. Block. Block runner. Mighty Blow Troll Slayer. Mighty Blow Troll Slayer. Guard, guard. Leader on a runner. And guard. Yippee. We turn off monitor one. There we go. Actually. Can do that. And we're back on Twitch. You guys all still there? Just started again. Oh, okay. He's receiving. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. There we go. I'm not sure where this guy's from, but I think he played in the tournament this morning for Europe. It'll be interesting to see what happens in this one, because the first one, I made two critical mistakes. One, my roster's wrong from the way I designed it. It's a legit roster, but I ended up with two skills on one of my Black Orcs when there should have been one skill on all four. So that's kind of painful. And then I used that player thinking he had block, and I took a boat down. And then on the second half of turn one, he fouled him and took him out for the game. And I played behind the eight ball from then on. One, two, three, four, five, six. Kick. Quick snap. Oh, I don't think that's going to affect him much. Well, here we go. Gotta be kidding me. First block. Ugh. Two for two. Two for three. Three for four. Let's see if I could return the favor. He's got a Mighty Blow Slayer kind of hanging out in the middle of nowhere. That I could hit. Oh, is this a guard guy? Let's get these marked up. He's missed one block so far this turn. Well, okay. I didn't screw anything up horribly on the first turn on that one. God, he's missed like one block so far. I don't know what to do about that. Jesus! He's missed one block in two turns. Oh, took one out. Durin went out. Now we both have a guard. I shouldn't have hit with that black orc. He's got to eventually, like, miss a block.
still behind that wall. This is crazy. It's 2 for 2 so far. Two for three. Three for four. Four for five. Five for six. You back, Dan? Hey, what's the command to see the list of all the people who are watching the game? I forget. Can somebody type that in the chat? Well, Dave's saying ship, different game, man. Same shit, different game. He's missing like one block a turn. That's crazy. That's insane. That's absolutely insane. Is there any way I can do that? 1, 2, 3, 4. I mean, this isn't even fair. Holy cow. There we go. Now we're getting some action. Oh, finally. Hey, Dave, is my audio sounding better? I don't think he liked that much.
Oh, his leader's out. Well, that's good. Neither one of us. Oh, man.
That stunk that that guy didn't come back. Hey, Mom.
Can I bring you dinner?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Hey Ken, how does my sound sound? How does my sound sound? I guess my audio sound. Dave was telling me it was kind of quiet. What do you guys think? Think I could get a 3-turn score? No. God dang it. Blitz, gotta be kidding me. Like, he's only been missing one block a turn up to this point, maybe two, and he's throwing 5, 6, 7 blocks. I just can't play with most of my team on the ground. Somehow I need to blow through his piling on my line there. The hell did the ball go? I didn't even see. Oh, it's right in front of me. Well, if I get somebody free... I have all my movement down the bottom side, though. Might be able to do something with that. maybe not. Boy, he really doesn't want that Mighty Blow guy. He's going after him with abandon. Oh, that's a good start. Hi, Mom.
Can you hear me?
Say hi to the internet.
Hello.
Oh, cool. My mom just brought me some dinner. All right. Let me finish my turn here. Oh, boy. These guys are here.
I got these for your birthday.
Oh, okay. Thanks.
We don't. No, I got you the whole pack, but we're sharing it. Let me see the cushion.
This one. And the smaller one fits right on his wheelchair.
Oh, good.
That's good. Super comfortable. This guy may be a goner. One, two, three. 3, 4, 5. Yeah, he can do that. Okay, blitz here. Hand off. No rerolls left. Think I'm good. Okay. Well, that was a really good turn. I don't know if I could score, but with no rerolls, Anka's runner can
get to me with some go for it. Nobody else. I got this chicken. It's really good. That is really good. Oh, there we go. All right, let's see what we got here. I have Block Mighty Blow here. I think that's everybody. Yep. Wow, that turned around a little bit. I'm going to turn on a space launch in the background and see what happens if it gets scrubbed or not.
Thank you. today.
Oh wow, two of his knockouts didn't come back. I killed a guy. Okay.
Yeah. We're pressurizing the Falcon 9 tanks. We're going to open the clamp arm around the second stage and begin to retract the strongback. We'll move back about 2 degrees. That'll get us the liftoff position. At liftoff, the strongback will then recline about 45 degrees.
Oh. Wow! Oh, now it's getting out of control.
After calling out, the strongback retract has started. On the left, you'll see it go back just a couple of degrees.
Stage 1, Arco, please. We are just 4 minutes away from liftoff. Again, at this moment, Bob and Doug are really just laser-focused on those displays. They have insight directly into Dragon and the Falcon 9. They're able to see where their fuel loading is at, how everything's progressing down with the count.
ATS, final setup started.
Three and a half minutes from launch.
And the strongback is now reclining away from the Falcon 9.
Alright, I guess we go for the kill here. Somebody skulled out there. Okay, let's see. Heat us out here. Got some chicken. Okay, we're gonna want to hand off.
quad skulls. Awesome. I got this guy right where I want him in quad skulls.
Oh, there it goes. Look at that. Watching the space launch here.
40 seconds into this historic mission. Flying crew on board Dragon and Falcon 9 is looking to go.
Falcon power function nominal. M1D drawdown.
We're throttling down to get ready for the period of maximum dynamic pressure.
Oh my god, this poor guy can't get anything right.
We're in the throttle button.
That's kind of how my last game went.
Okay. So.
Trajectory. Already almost 200 miles downrange from the Kennedy Kennedy Space Center. Nominal trajectory. Continuing.
Looks like you may have this one in hand. Playing 11 on 7 right now. And
displays that they are seeing right now themselves.
I think I may have them now. What do you guys think? Those of you who are kibitzing. Oni, I seem to have come back and the blocks all went my way after the first couple of turns. I mean, I had two killed guys, two knockouts. And I'll have control until the last half of turn 16.
Targeted orbit. So exciting today.
bird on.
And it's right at about 12 minutes when the dragon will separate. Looks like we saw a 0G indicator floating around there. I know Bob and Doug owe us a little bit about what exactly that is that they brought up with them.
Before separation, before Dragon initiates separation from the second stage, they do make sure to make, they do ensure that the vehicle is not spinning and is in good condition before we separate.
That's right, the upper stage does small attitude maneuver using cold gas thrusters built into the rocket body itself.
Exactly, so we do expect that separation to occur in about a minute from now, but they do wait until they have full confirmation that it is ready to separate. Such cool views. I cannot get over this view that we're seeing right now. Bob and Doug on the right screen, inside of Crew Dragon, out in space.
Yeah, already 200 kilometers over planet Earth, or a little over 124 miles, traveling in excess of 27,000 meters per second, or about 16,000 miles per hour. So again, we're just standing by. That separation event should be coming up shortly. Then they'll begin a series of checks on the Draco thrusters that are going to be used to maneuver and then power Dragon on its flight to the International Space Station. Standing by for separation.
Expected loss of signal, holdups.
It sounded like we had an expected LOS loss of signal with one of the ground stations. Waiting for confirmation now of that
Dragon separation confirmed.
Dragon separation confirmed.
There is a great view right in front of you. Dragon separating. And there's that call out. Dragon is now officially making its way to the International Space Station today.
SpaceX, with that separation call, and we have a few words for you from our FUMBBL NAF team.
Dragon, Chief Engineer on Dragon to Ground. Bob Duck, on behalf of the entire launch team, thanks for flying with Falcon 9 today. We hope you enjoyed the ride and wish you a great mission.
Thanks, Bob. Congratulations to you and the F9 team for the first human ride for Falcon 9, and it was incredible. Appreciate all the hard work, and thanks for the great ride to space.
Copy all.
Oh, I'd like to be proud of you guys and the rest of the team. Thank you so much for what you've done for us today, putting America back into low Earth orbit up from the Florida coast.
Copy all. Good luck. Godspeed.
And service section Draco checkouts. No scum deploys in progress.
Copy all. We're monitoring.
The core here in Hawthorne giving the crew a heads up that we have confirmation the nose cone is deploying. So again, that nose cone is going to open up a little bit more than 90 degrees, goes up to about, I think, 105 degrees, and that's going to expose the actual docking ring and the hatch that they're going to be going through once they attach to the International Space Station. And also four of those Draco thrusters, we call the forward bulkhead thrusters, that are going to be used for these major phase burns or firings of those thrusters to actually raise their orbit gradually over the coming hours. Also heard good activation of the ECLS, that's the Environmental Control and Life Support System. That's everything controlling their atmosphere. Just keeping Dragon a nice, safe, habitable environment where they're going to be living for the next 19 hours until they arrive at the space station.
Right, exactly. Falcon 9's job may be done for today, but the mission is not over. Crew Dragon's job is not done. As you can see, Bob and Doug are still inside Crew Dragon making their way. It will be a 19-hour trip to the International Space Station before they dock tomorrow morning. Such cool views. I love that we can get these live views here and see and watch what they're doing. now that they are in orbit.
Yeah, it's incredible to just be looking over their shoulder to be along for the ride. And we're going to be with them, and we're going to be with all of you the entire way for their journey to the space station. We're going to be covering live throughout. Bob and Doug will obviously have a sleep period where they'll get about 8 hours of sleep a little bit later today before they wake up for all of their final approach. One of the major things we are looking forward to in the next couple of hours is going to be their first turn at the controls. So they're actually going to be using those touchscreen displays to take control and manually pilot Dragon. We'll walk you through what that's going to look like, and assuming we have some good ground station coverage, we'll be able to get views right inside Dragon, looking over their shoulder as they manipulate the controls at the display. But I mean, we had a smooth ride uphill, both stages of the Falcon 9 doing their job, placing Bob and Doug in orbit. I mean, this is a day, this is a historical day. This is us kicking off that new era of spaceflight that we've all been talking about and longing for since the space shuttle program came to an end in 2011.
Yes.
The weather cooperated.
Yes. Second time's a charm.
Right.
All right. So, day for the history books. As you can see, we have lost some live signal there, but the mission still continues, and we're going to send it over to KSC to continue broadcasting live with you.
Also signal you from them.
Yeah, Jesse and Dan, we are just in awe over here. And I woke up this morning, looked at the weather forecast, I was like, man, we're going to be back here on Sunday, but we did it. And the room cleared out, everybody was outside watching, and inside, the lights were shaking, the cameras were shaking. Lauren came back in with tears in her eyes. This is really amazing.
I can't believe that I saw it with my own eyes. This is, I'm a little bit speechless. Just so grateful that we got them up there, and there's a lot more to go, a lot more to go. I'm so happy they're safe right now. I'm so happy.
Yeah, we were talking about it. It's amazing what we're supposed to do when we work together.
Yes, American astronauts, American rockets, American soil, showing what America can do when we come together as a team and blast Doug and Bob off to the cosmos. This is what it's all about, and their families.
Hey guys, that are watching me on Twitch, it looks like this guy may have conceded. I did kind of have my foot on his throat there. It's going to get pretty ugly for his team, but, you know, it's a tournament. Wish he would keep playing. I mean, I've gotten my butt whooped more than once in a tournament and stuck in and played till the end and just had fun. But, yeah, with guard block, strength four everywhere here, he was going to have a really hard time coming back. And this guy's just parked here waiting to score 2-1. So they're talking to the admins right now to figure this out. If you're not watching, the rocket launch in Florida for the Falcon 9 and the Dragon. Falcon 9 landed back on that drone ship, which is always awesome when you see that. And the capsule's up in orbit now, in low orbit, and it'll hit the space station in like, or the International Space Station in like 19 hours.
We have done it. It's been way too long. I want to give a lot of credit to Charlie Bolden. He was my predecessor as the NASA administrator. He fought hard for this program at a time when it didn't get any support in Congress. We now have an administration that is fully supportive of our spaceflight initiatives, not just on the exploration, discovery, going to the moon, onto Mars, but also from a Space Force perspective. Our budgets are going up, things are strong, and today was just just an amazing day. You know, one of the things the president did right out of the gate when he became president is he created what's called the National Space Council. And he put the vice president as chairman of the National Space Council. And on that National Space Council, you've got the Secretary of Defense and the Secretary of State and the Secretary of Commerce, the Secretary of Transportation, the Secretary of Education, the chairman of Joint Chiefs, all of these different amazing individuals that deal with space day in and day out. A lot of people don't realize how many parts of the federal government deal with space. And the vice president invited those members of the National Space Council here as well. So we just had, and then we had members of Congress, bipartisan members of Congress, Republicans and Democrats, who have been involved in supporting this program, you know, for a long time now. So I'll just tell you, I'm breathing a sigh of relief. But I will also tell you, I'm not going to celebrate until Bob and Doug are home safely. Tomorrow they're
going to... Guess we can turn that off now so you guys can hear me a little bit better. I'm still waiting for them to kind of admin this. I'm going to step away from the mic here for a couple of minutes. My dad is having some problems with his leg, and I'm here at the house helping him out. I'm going to go upstairs and check on him and my mom and see if everything's going good up there. And I'll be back in just a couple of minutes. They told me not to leave the game until they did. Yes, it is very lame, Kent. Very disappointed, but it looks like I'll get the win at 1-1 or 2-1, something like that. But I lose a chance at a bunch of more casualties, you know, and in a tournament, that's, you know, important. But bottom line is I'll get the win, I guess. But it looks like he had some internet problems or conceded. I'm not really sure which. Let me post a link here for those of you who didn't see let's see. Oh, So for those of you who All right, guys, I think I'm going to call it. They're going to admin this game. The guy conceded to me in a private message, so I'm going to switch to non-live here, go check on my folks, see how they're doing. Let's see.